Hi, I'm Artur, and in this video I'm going to show you how to render with Redshift on GarageFarm. I will use a Cinema4D and Redshift setup. Before we begin, let me sidetrack for a moment to give you a more general overview. There are actually two ways to render with Redshift on GarageFarm. One is our desktop service, where you rent a workstation and use it remotely. There you install your own software, open your scene and start rendering in a similar way you render on your own machine. The second way is to use the regular GarageFarm service. The workflow is exactly the same as with CPU rendering. Whichever to choose is a matter of your own preferences. I consider the second way more convenient and just a better option for Redshift overall. If you haven't used GarageFarm yet, it's quite simple. You go to the website GarageFarm.net, click Sign Up and create an account. Then you log in and go to the Downloads tab. From here, you download Render Beamer. After you install Render Beamer and log into it, you go to the Plugins tab and install a plugin for your 3D software. In my case, it's Cinema, and I have it already installed. Now, you must understand that GarageFarm workflow consists of three components. A plugin in the 3D software from which you initiate the whole process, the Render Beamer, which is our uploader downloader, and the web manager, where you manage your render tasks. Let's start and launch the plugin. The warning we can see here is an advice to start with rendering a test and only later render the whole scene. By starting with a test, you can make sure your scene renders correctly on the farm. A test also provides you a pretty accurate cost estimation. I will show you how to use it soon. Set main render output. If you see this error, it means in render settings, saving output is disabled. You need to enable it. Not only saving must be enabled, but also output path must be set. So let's set the path. Now, after preparing render settings, let's run the plugin from the menu. In the plugin, you see a list of cameras. You need to enable the camera you want to render and set the frame range for each. In this example, I'm going to render frames 1 to 100. Because I will start with a test, I will set a step 10. It means the farm will render every 10th frame. If you use takes in your scenes, you will be happy to know we do support takes. This scene, however, doesn't include takes. If they existed, they would be displayed here as a list. Let's get back to the animation tab and start uploading by clicking Send to Farm. As you can see, uploading is on the way. When it finishes, a window like this should appear. To continue, you click the green button. A drop settings screen will appear. If you missed the window with the green button somehow, don't worry. You can easily bring it by clicking your scene here in the left panel. Before we click submit, let's review our settings. If you forgot to set something in the plugin, you can still change it here. You can set the frame range, the resolution, you set the priority here. Let's use medium. By the way, you can change the priority at any time during rendering. The Cinema version should be already set to the one you use. You can also change the output format. If you don't want to save the multipass files, you can turn them off here. Frames per execution, This one is more difficult to explain. It's connected with the efficiency of the framework. Basically, the faster your frames render, the better it is to increase the value. The default value is 10, and it should be good for most scenes. Drop node limit allows you to slow down the speed of rendering by reducing the maximum number of nodes that can render this particular job. You may wonder why you would ever use that. Well, there are some use cases for this option, especially on low priority, when you have a few jobs in the queue and you want to prioritize them differently without changing the priority. The last one is add job as paused. You can use it if you want your scene to take a place in the render queue, but you don't want it to start rendering just yet. Let's click Submit and start our test render. We can switch between two styles of jobs list. In the jobs information, we can see that the cost of that test was 21 cents, and a full render would cost us $2.10. The test finished, and we can check our frames. Frames are automatically downloaded by RenderBeamer. However, you can speed up the process by using refresh option. If everything is correct, we can start rendering of all frames. Let's right-click on the job and choose Render Full Range. Now we just have to wait for final rendering. Waiting time depends on scene complexity and selected render priority. Higher render priority means more render nodes for your job. The render finished. As you can see, Beamer is downloading full render frames now. It cost us 96 cents, less than we estimated. Such anomaly happens when the frame's render time is very short, which is the case with this test scene. All the frames have downloaded. I hope you enjoyed this basic tutorial. I wish you happy rendering with Redshift.